I'll have nothing to say in the morning if I can't remember my dreams. Still have a feeling that something was buzzing in and out of my head like a bee. I can't figure out why I woke with nothing but a croak in the words that I spoke, when all I was trying to do was call out for help. Something broke, nothing came out when I yelled, "Get away from me." I'll have nothing to say sometimes. I'm better with words if I can get them to rhyme. Give me a minute, I'll get it. Give me the morning, and I can figure out why I won't fold to the brim or on the edge of a joke. Heavy like a limb or light as a kid. Given the time I could remember it, would you stay with me? Goodbye, I love you. Going on in my brain, I'm wishing away. Nothing, nothing to say when all I'm after is greeting the day. But you could stay and dance it away with me. Would you stay and dance it away with me? Cigarettes and tunes, you were staring at the moon, but I silver linings on a cloud, taking a bow, leaves of red, yellow, and gold. Heat lightning before a summer storm and more to blame than I care to admit. Couldn't forget. We're blood, we're bones, we break, we spill. Love didn't die, it just got ill. I don't mind, I'll be crazy anyway. In any light on any day, I'll be crazy to somebody. So I learned you only brought back what you took from my bones and nothing more. Guess I got used to being left alone by you. I'll be crazy anyway. In any light on any day, I'll be crazy to somebody. Crazy to somebody. Crazy to someone. Crazy. I could hold you and tell you it's okay. It's just today and other things that I could say. Hold the winter daphne close to your face. And I could have told you that you wanted to leave me, but you would have not. Myself clear. So why again are we right back here? Maybe it's
Hi, my name is Kate Rhudy, and I'm from Raleigh, North Carolina. What you just listened to is some songs from some old records and some newer songs and songs that are to be released. I believe the first song I played was Dance It Away, and that is the first single I ever came out with after my first record, and it was produced and recorded in my friend Jack Hallenbeck's childhood bedroom over the summer of 2019, and it sounded very different than it does on the recording because we used a drum machine, and I did not have one here today. And then I think the next song I played was Boy from Charlevoix, which is a song off of my first record, Rock and Roll Ain't For Me. And it is about a boy from Charlevoix, Michigan. And I wrote it while I was living in Boone, North Carolina. And the next song I played was Crazy. And I wanted to play that one because I've had it written for a long time, but I've never had it recorded. And I like having it in different stages. Until I can figure out how to wrap it up, put a bow on it. And then the last song I played was Opacity, and it's that song is going to be on a record that I just finished during the quarantine. I've been playing the violin since I was 5 and started playing the guitar as a teen, but didn't think it was going to be my career until I didn't think anything else was going to be my career, until I ruled out everything else. Me and my sister grew up going to Fiddler's Conventions in Southwest Virginia. Our parents have some family land out there that we grew up on during the summers and whenever we could go. And I grew up with the Suzuki method of classical violin. And the Fiddler's Conventions were fun because we were already being trained to learn by ear. So to sit in on jams and kind of learn on the spot and perform was very fun for us. Well, I've played in other people's bands before, but I haven't. Like, I played in Skylar's band one time, or like Libby Rodenbo's band one time. I've been in some cover bands. But in college, I was in two different. One was a folk Americana trio where I played the fiddle and sang harmonies. Another one was like a pretty, I wouldn't say radio country, but country band that I also played fiddle and sang harmonies in. You definitely have to like it. I'm not even going to say you have to practice, but you have to like it, you have to want to do it, and you have to be proactive about getting out there and talking to people and asking questions. And I would say, find another job while you're at it. But definitely don't try to force something that you're not very interested in the first place. Like, if this is what you want to do, you should do it. Well, it attracted me because I liked having a community where I didn't have to be talking about music all the time, or I had something else to commiserate about with people, because sometimes, I mean, as with any job, I think being a musician can be stressful, and you just don't want to be talking about it all the time. It'll wear you thin. And I also think, yeah, having something else to do really, one begets the other. Like, I'm more inspired to do music if I've been doing work all week, if I've been on my feet all week. During quarantine, I've been not working in a service industry for the most part, and also not really doing a lot of music. So, oh yeah, I did record an entire record. But other than that, I really haven't been doing much music. I think working on the record has led me to not be as creative, like, in writing new songs, because I'm really focused and excited about this one project. And also, when I finished it, when I finished the record, I was listening to it with these noise-canceling headphones, and it felt like, I guess they were just really good headphones, but it felt like somebody else was singing into my face, like inches from my face, and I was like, I just forgotten completely about where those songs had come from in the first place, like 3 years ago, 4 years ago, less than a year ago. And that kind of emotion hit me, and it was like, it's done. And I feel like it allows me to start working on new stuff. But I still have to put this one out, so got a lot of work to do. But I had just done a month-long cross-country tour, opening up for one of my favorite bands, Mandolin Orange, and then I was about to leave for another tour. So I was kind of like working at the bar and ready to go, and then quarantine hit, and I was stuck at home. For sure. Once the stress was off to do something, once the pressure was gone, I made a record, and it was so much fun. And we did a lot of it at the studio, but everything that wasn't the full band or the lead vocal or something, me and Andrew, who produced my first record, produced this one, we just did in my back room or in his basement. And like, that was so nice to do that every couple weeks and not have a timeline on it and to actually have fun with it. And that was really cool. Definitely since we did it during COVID, there was a lot of like everyone was wearing masks and everyone was tested, and you had to, there was just an added layer of intensity, maybe, or just like, it wasn't that there was pressure on it, but it definitely made it seem more important than maybe if it wasn't a scary time. I don't know anything about production. I didn't know anything about production, and I don't know anything about songwriting, and I didn't know anything about touring. And I think just once you start doing it, you just believe in yourself that you can do it, and you just have to be doing it. Like with production, I'd just been paying attention and wanting to, like, I wanted to be there for mixing, which I'm not sure was a good idea, but I think I learned a lot just by being in the room. And then with touring, I would say learn where you can get some healthy food. Stop for your bathroom breaks. Books on tape. Don't be afraid to ask, where am I supposed to go right now? What am I supposed to be doing? And take your alone time, because sometimes you're going to be really surrounded by people. Yeah. Make a space for yourself wherever you are. Make a home for yourself wherever you are. With songwriting, yeah, I just like writing things down when I think of them. And I don't finish songs quickly. I don't think I've finished a whole song, maybe one, this entire year. So I think something will come together soon enough if I put my mind to it. If you run it by a friend, don't be afraid to run it by a friend and let them give input. Maybe one day I'll just go through my notes and put it all together, and then all that'll be a song. I don't know. I would just say take care of your space. This is maybe unsolicited advice. I'm not sure this is an advice interview, but it can be, and it is now. So take care of your space. Guard your space. Take care of your time. Don't do anything you don't want to do. Live shows TBD, but I have a website. It's katerhudy.com. My name is spelled K-A-T-E-R-H-U-D-Y. The other day my dad said to me, are you ever going to change your band name? And I was like, no. He's like, good. I like being Kate Rudy's dad. It was really cute. But yeah, I think I'm on everything. Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, under my name. And Bandcamp as well. Oh, Spotify, Apple Music. Yes. The works. I don't care where you stream. Do what you need to do. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Kat, and I go by awaymsg, and I went to NC State. I live locally here. I went to NC State for plant biology, and this was a while ago, and then I did go back to do like a computer science certification a couple years ago. I really liked learning about plants and biology, and I also, when I was very young, I like had a dream of becoming a scientist. But then it turns out in reality, I really didn't enjoy doing science in the real world, mostly because it's like really repetitive. I started producing music a really long time ago in high school, and what happened was, like, I grew up playing classical piano, and I never, like, all I knew was playing pieces, so it's like learning a song on like sheet music or something and then just playing it back. But at some point in high school, I met some other people, and they found out I played piano, and they were like, "Wow, so you play keyboard? We should jam." And I was like, "Jam? What's that?" And it turns out it's like you just kind of get together and like make up stuff. And I think up until that point, I never considered the possibility of like just making stuff up, because everything I learned was like very rigid. And then one of the people that I met, this guy named Sebi, he was making music on his computer, and I was like, "Wow, you can make music on your computer?" And he's like, "Yeah." And he showed me Reason 3, and then he gave me a copy of it, and he showed me how to use it. So that was how I got started. So while I was attending State, I was making music, but I would say it was not very good. I didn't make anything that was particularly like that. I mean, I guess I was proud of it at the time, but I guess that's how it always is. Is like, you know, in the moment, you're like, "Wow, this is so awesome," and then like you learn more stuff, and then you're like, "Oh, dang, it wasn't really that awesome. But there's so much more I could have done," or something. But yeah, so I was making music then. I spent a lot of time learning how to do it. And it is cool to like go back and like listen to like old stuff that just like sits on my computer or something, and kind of like it's like there's memories attached to it. So it's almost like going through like an old diary. Well, I played 3 songs. One of them is old, and then 2 of them are new that I've been working on, and I'm trying to build up an EP. But with the pandemic, it has been hard to come up with ideas, or like it's been hard to have inspiration, I guess. But I am excited about the new stuff, because it's very different from before. So I used to typically make like kind of sad music. Well, a long time ago, I made like very, very ecstatic, happy music. And then after that, I like decided to do the opposite and make like kind of like introspective and like sad, slow music. And in like 2019, I was having a rough time, and I was going to start making music, and I was like, "Dang, I think I'm going to make some music, some sad music," because I was feeling sad. But then I had this idea where it was like, what if instead of making music about how I'm currently feeling, how about I make stuff about how I want to feel and immerse myself in those emotions? And that was kind of how this started. So everything is very like, I feel like, has a very like kind of positive sort of vibe. I just want to do something that's like kind of like a wholesome, positive kind of thing, where I also had this thought at the time where like I felt like if everyone is really angry and depressed generally, then it must be counterculture to feel good. So that was kind of like the idea behind it. And I was listening to a lot of stuff at the time that was pretty inspirational to me, I guess. I'm excited about, hopefully, after people get vaccinated and stuff, we can maybe get back into like a little bit of more hanging out and seeing people in real life. I think one thing that was really helpful to me was that when I listen to music and I hear something and I'm like, wow, this song's really good. I like to think about what about that song made me really like it. Because a lot of times it's not like the entirety of the song itself. It's like some essence of that song. So it'd be like, wow, I really like the way they do their, I don't know, like drum rhythm or something like that in this song. Or like, I really like the way that they release tension in this way. And then you kind of build up like a catalog of that kind of stuff. And then when you make music, instead of making stuff in a particular style, you can just pull from this catalog of things that you personally like. And I think in that way, then all the music you make will always be true to yourself. Well, I have a SoundCloud, soundcloud.com/away-msg. But almost all my stuff is like private. But eventually I do want to release this EP, which I think is going to be sometime this summer. And it's going to be called I'm Glad We Are Friends.